Hi everyone, in before video we seen how to add scripts and everything. Now in this video we'll see how to move the player in our game. If you're not subscribed to my channel, just hit that subscribe button.
Let's watch this amazing.
How we can move the player? How to move the player? So I think go to scripts and right click, go to create a new C# script, that movement player, and don't give the spaces between the script. It's also an error because the class name should not be spaces. Just click this one, click that script, it's automatically open in Visual Studio. So I already explained what the things are there in before video. Now in this video I want to write player movement. So before writing the player movement, I want to explain we need to move the player. I need player should move from one side, from left to right, and you can observe, I'll explain. You can see that player should move from left and right, right? Left side, you can see left side and right side, right? And the player should not move from top and down. So you can see, just go to edit and go to project settings and go to input, go to input and click this axis, go to horizontal. You can see if you want to move the player from left hand side, you should use the horizontal. If you want to move the player from up and down, you should use vertical. So I want to use the axis as a horizontal, right? So just I think it's very clear. I want to move the player from left and right. So just close this one. And so my target is I want to move the player from left and right. So just I'll create. First of all, to move the player, I want to create float move. So I'm giving some speed like 0f. So just I created, and it should be private because I don't want it to be public, just private. And also create another variable, we need some speed to move the player. So I want to keep this one as a public because I want to change the movement speed in also in Unity editor. That's why I'm keeping as a public. And I'll say what is the difference between private and public also in future, and keep it as a speed and give some speed, otherwise leave it. And it should be float, right? The speed of the player should be float. So I think it's very clear. And we created only two things, that is a player movement and speed. Now in player movement, I want to create a rigid body. I want to add a rigid body. So I want to add a rigid body. Just add private. So rigid body 2D, and rigid body having two types, that is rigid body. If you are doing 3D game, you should have rigid body, you should add. And I'm doing the 2D game, so I'll add rigid body 2D and keep the variable name as a RIB. What you can, the variable name, what you want, you can keep. Just you should, the script wants to know that you are getting that component to in your script. So just by using RBs and variable name we created, you can see the name of this, and get component, we should, the script has to know we are getting that component. You can see, just click here and rigid body 2D. You can see this is the way to getting the component to your script. Yes, I done getting the component. Now my task is the player should move left and right, right? Left side and right side. Just in update only, just write move is equal to, because I have already created a variable name is move, and equal to input dot. Why I'm using input, I already explained here. Just go to edit and go to project settings, and you can find input. You can see that it's an input axis, right? In that axis having horizontal and vertical, just go to input dot get axis. We have to get that axis, right? get axis that is horizontal, and the name should be same, and spelling also H should be capital O R I Z O M T A L. Same name should be given here. Just close this one. So we are getting that axis here. Now we need to give some velocity to move the player, right? So RIG, that means rigid body dot, sorry, I assigned a variable like RIB dot velocity. Just I'm giving some velocity, that means force to move the player. So new is a keyword, and now we are using we are working on 2D, right? 2D having only two axes, that is x axis and y axis. Coming to 3D, we are having x axis, y axis and z axis. Now we are doing 2D game, so we need only two axes, that is x axis and y axis. Just click. So that is I am using vector 2. If you are doing a 3D game, just it's in vector 3. That is only the difference. So I am using 2D game, just x, y. Just x comma y. So x-axis and y-axis. So vector 2 having x-axis and y-axis. In x-axis, I want to move the player with speed, and y-axis with an velocity. So move dot speed. So I want to give a speed, and you can see the speed variable already declared here. Velocity dot, we have to give y axis. Just close semicolon and control S. Just control, don't forget to save the script. Just control S, make it as, and close this one. Yes, now I want to add it this script to player. Just drag here and drop here, and you can find the player movement script was added here. So now give the speed as 2 or 3, whatever it may be. I'm giving the speed as 2. Just handle the keyboard, left arrow and right arrow. And you can see the player is moving. Of course, the player is moving very nice. And you can see the player is moving. Yes, but unfortunately, it's moving and it's rotating, right? So we don't want to rotate the player. Just click this one and go to rigid body. Go to rigid body and just extract this one and freeze rotation z axis. And now you can see the difference. Just play the button and operate left arrow, right arrow to move the player. And you can see, yes. Yes, of course, it's not freezing and it's also moving. And just click this one and yes, given the speed is 2, right? Yes, you can find it's moving from, you can observe here. Now it's not rotating because we freeze it the Z axis, and you can free because we added the circle collider. That's it. And you can find because, and you can observe it's an back of that, and you should have to change the tree's positions also. Just go to other objects and click this one. I think tree A, and change this position to 1. And you can click this one also. I think 1, of course it's 1. And now you can check the difference. Just I'm operating. Yes, yes. It's back, so it's the player is front. Now this one should be back, right? So tree H should be back. Just keep it as 0, not 0 or 1, and keep it is, it should be main layer, and otherwise you can keep second layer also, should be 0, and you can try that one, and it should be front or back. Of course, it's in back. So our target is moon default 1. And this one also moon default 1. I think it's clear now. Yes, it's pakka clear. So just now try to operate. It's colliding the objects. But still, it's in front. So just order of layer should be zero. So I think better to keep one and keep this as a third layer or main layer or default, or think better to keep just keep one, and because this is also default one and this is also default one, this is also default one and this is also default one, that's why it is also default. Coming to this one, this is also default one, and coming to this one, this is, so just keep back side and just play the button. Yes, I'm pressing the arrows now. The player is moving front, back, and player is moving. So if I take just open the player. If I take the bounce none, if I keep the bounce is none, you can see the player, the difference in player, because it's a bird, right? Every movement it should be in the sky, not should be in the floor. Sometimes it should be on the floor. So that is why I added this physics material. So you can see it's moving front, it's moving back. So I removed the bounces. So I want the player should always bounce because it's a bird. So always it should be bounce. Just click this one, add bounce and close. Now you can see the difference. Yes, this is the small video, and yes, of course it's the player movement is very clear, but I need to write some conditions. That is, if movement is zero, that means the speed of the movement is 0 f, I want something. And if is, suppose the movement of player should be zero, it should be freeze, it should not move. So if the player should here, it should not move if I pressing also. So I'll write some conditions here, just observe. So I'll write some conditions. If move greater than 0 f, just copy this and paste it here, it should be same. And if move less than 0 f, and copy and paste it here. And if move, I think I already written if, and we should use else if, right? Now here else, else, and it should be here, it should be zero because it should not move. Just save it as you can see the smooth moving the game object. You can see the object is moving in smooth. Just play the button. Yes, of course it's moving smooth. You can observe before and after. So it's moving smooth and it's not bad. So this is the way to add a movement of player. I think the script was very clear. And if you have any doubts, you can please comment in comment section. I'll always help you to reach final output. Okay, that's all for this video. I'll come with another video. I want to jump the player. So already it's bouncing, but if we press the space button or anything, I want to jump the player.
I hope this video is helpful to you. In future, definitely I'll do more videos and more things. And let's subscribe this channel because if you support me, I'll do more and more videos. And do like and share also. And if you want to ask.